that.
Christ, this is spooky.
What's that?
Grim sticking wires in your head, man.
I just need to sync the encryption signature between his subdermals and Fort Meade.
Don't like that.
I know. It's for after we land. You better hurry up, Grim. We touch down in Georgia in 15.
I'm already done. Lambert? Hey, Irving, do you read me?
Tell her I read her.
He reads you.
Good. You ready to get to work?
I'd feel better if I knew what was going on.
You know what you need to. The CIA lost a mole inside Georgian President Kombe Nikolaidze's cabinet. Her name is Alice Madison. They sent in Agent William Robert Blaustein to find her and lost him, too.
Are we working with the CIA's cooperation?
Blaustein is outfitted with subdermals just like yours. That'll be your best lead to find him.
You didn't answer my question.
We'll tell you what you need to know. You're not out there alone, Fisher. Through me, you're attached to a dozen of the best NSA minds we have. There are political complexities with Georgia you'd need a week to understand.
I've just about memorized this speech, Lambert.
Well, start believing it. This is Third Echelon's maiden voyage, and we need it to go smooth as butter. You're about to touch down in Georgia. Get ready.
Tbilisi Old Town, Tbilisi, Georgia, October 16th, 2004, 20:01 hours. Locate CIA agents Blaustein and Madison. Agent Allison Madison worked covertly in the Georgian political arena for 2 years, securing a role in President Nikolaidze's cabinet after his coup d'etat. She vanished on October 3rd. On October 7th, Special Agent Robert Blaustein was sent in to find her. He vanished on October 11th. Greetings, fellow Earthlings. It has been a long time. Welcome to Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell in first-person perspective. It has been a long time, and I realize I've been inactive on this channel for close to a year or so. But I digress. Let's just get ahead with this mission. And, let's start this.
Fisher, the sun's down. Time to go to work. Finding Agent Blaustein is our first priority. To locate him through a local NSA contact.
I'm on my way.
And stay off the streets. There's a heavy cop presence in this town. We don't have Washington's backing if this turns into an incident. Details on your offset.
So, as you can see right off the bat, that this is actually in first-person perspective. You cannot see Sam at all. And what I'm using here are basically three mods, modifications to the game. One of them is actually a widescreen patch, which enables you to see, you know, or rather play the game in 1920x1080 or the similar 16:9 ratio. And I think it is also compatible with the 16:10 ratio, and maybe even ultra widescreen ratios as well. I'm not quite certain about that, but yeah. The other mod would be a lighting and shadows fix, which essentially emulates old graphics hardware such as DG Voodoo 2. It's called DG Voodoo 2, and it emulates old graphics cards such as the NVIDIA 4800. And what that essentially does is makes the shadows and lighting look just that much prettier. The texture packs have also been upgraded. Let's just wait for the dialogue here.
Inside there.
Why would I tell you what you already know? You're gonna have to hurry. Grim's daughter's comparing a dog star drone sonar to the warehouse blueprints.
Sam, Grim's daughter here. I say jump. Don't ask how high, just do it. You should get to this fine. There's a room directly across the hall. Go there now.
Get through this fine.
Get the hall and go to the stairwell at the far end. Make it fast. You've only got a few seconds.
Yeah, so as I was saying, basically it's called DG Voodoo 2 and it emulates old graphics hardware. And, I've also added some texture packs from the PS3 Masters. So it might be looking a little prettier than it's supposed to.
Take a left just ahead and cut through the room. You'll find a stairwell on the opposite corner. Take it to the top floor.
Well, that's that, but apart from that, the fourth mod which I'm using is the first person mod, and
the contact is in this room. Let's hope to God he's still alive.
Apart from just making it appear in first person, it does change a few things here and there as well.
Yeah. I'm in this city. I'm gonna get you out of here.
Don't bother. I'm as good as dead. You're looking for Blaustein and Madison.
Yeah.
Madison was deep into Nicolazza's cabinet. She was onto something big. Blaustein must have figured it out.
How do I find him?
Blaustein's black box, the tracking relay for his subdermals. It's stashed in his safe house just east of Moravi Square.
Lambert, do we have resources to evac this guy?
I said don't bother. Whatever Madison found, it's big. She kept saying proof would mean war. I think Nicolás wanted... Oh.
You're gonna say checked out.
Leave the corpse for the fire. Less to explain to his family.
You've got a safe exit on the west side of the room. Take it.
Lambert, cool deserver. Anyway, so yeah, apart from just making it, moving the camera closer to Sam's face, it does a few other things as well. It's supposed to make your footsteps make more noise, and it is supposed to tighten the spread radius of your guns, both the handgun and the rifle.
My best.
Good. Blaustein's black box is your next objective. He's running standard agency tradecraft. You'll find the box behind a fake bookshelf or wall panel.
But that being said, what I personally feel like is that it actually makes your footsteps make less noise, because I'm able to, you know, move pretty fast through some of these areas, but that could also be because, you know, the screen is far more zoomed in. The next few videos do convince me of this, that
because it
actually makes you more silent.
Orders. I speak to Vyacheslav Grinko or nobody. As Grinko, yes, sir, this is Ketevan. We finished searching the American's apartment. There is nothing else there. If five more bugs, two cameras, and some electronics we can't ID. They are already on their way to the ministry. Of course. Thank you, sir.
So this is essentially an attempt to turn this game into a tactical shooter. And despite that, I personally, as you can see already, I am attempting to play this game through stealth, and here is where, like, sneak through this game. But here's where, you know, the difference between the first person perspective and the third person really, you know, is greatly exemplified. It's the fact that you can't peek around corners. You can only see what your character sees. And in order to see things, you need to expose yourself.
Everywhere. The place is clean. Don't cross Grinko. Intruder!
And I think I spent a little too long there, so that's why I got caught. I initially decided to flee, but then I decided to enter and exploit, you know, this mod for what it is supposed to be, that is a first-person shooter. And yeah, these shots weren't too accurate, but as you can see, the reticle does not spread at all, no matter how much I move the crosshairs. And I doubt there is an alarm at this point in the game, but I just go ahead and decide to, you know, like, take the lights out and hide the bodies in the shadows nonetheless. Just keeping it clean, keeping things clean, so to speak. At any rate, another thing that this mod is, you know, personally enabling me to do is, well, it's sort of encouraging me to play the game, you know, play the stealth part of the game a little more aggressively, because as you'll soon notice me doing, I will be trying things that I normally wouldn't have tried before while playing with the third person mod. And it could just be that I've, you know, played the game quite often, that you know, like, since I've been playing the game so much that it's sort of become, you know, a new thrill for me. But yeah.
What's the news?
Blaustein's heart stopped beating 43 hours ago.
Any reason the CIA wouldn't know about this?
Nope.
Nice of them to share.
The subdermal went offline 6 hours after he died. The last active position was in a police station a few blocks away. Check your opsat.
It sort of reminds me of this, you know, Chinese quote. I believe it's a Chinese quote, which goes, there is no need to fear the enemy outside if there is no enemy within. And yeah, the CIA keeping secrets sort of just reminded me of that quote just now. Fun fact, it's actually the fourth time that I'm recording this voiceover. Oh yeah, this is a post-gameplay voiceover commentary, just for the sake of, you know, complete transparency. What happened was I was dubbing over it and it turned out to be on mute, and the second time I did that I lost the recording, my mistake. The third time I did that, it turned out that my recording hardware, my boss recording hardware, wasn't the best in the, you know, world. Yeah, so as you'll see in just a bit, like I'll be playing the stealth far more aggressively, but the second thing is, like, despite having the first person, the limitations of first person, it makes the game a little easier in the sense that you can actually peek through stuff, because the game wasn't really made for a first person mod, at least the campaign wasn't, and I don't think they introduced spies versus mercs here. But here's a trick, neat little trick that I saw in one of the speedruns that I watched of this game. You can literally just jump up the wall and grab the sledge here, and you don't even need to deal with the police officers downstairs. And while I don't really know whether this is faster, but I think this is a more sure way of crossing this level, or at least just this section of this stage. So yeah, like, it never ceases to surprise me that, you know, no matter how many times I play this game, I'll always find something new when it comes to, you know, like exploring this game, or exploring avenues to sneak past people, or, you know, just if you're just having fun with the game, if you're just playing around, you don't even need to be serious. You can actually, you know, surprise yourself quite often with how versatile this game can be. So yeah, I mean, I personally consider it one of the ageless classics, even though it has not aged that well, especially considering the clunky controls and, you know, the platformer sections. But despite that, it's still a charm to play, and I mean, I love playing it. I have played it around 5 or 6 times already, and it never gets old. So yeah, I mean, they just don't make games like this anymore. Now, typically, I would, you know, wait in the nook here until that guy goes back past me. But like I said, I just found myself playing a little more aggressively this time around, even though I am trying to be more sneaky. And I just waited for the guy to come down in this, you know, shadow right here. And another thing that I've noticed about this game, like, currently I am at CIHQ, and I was actually recording in the same, you know, busted up gear. So I'm gonna have to do voiceovers for all of them as well. It's a pain, but I don't want to, you know, publish videos which have lower quality voice records. Like, I don't know who saw me there, but somebody apparently saw me, or maybe somebody heard me. But anyway, that's that. So yeah, another thing that I'm convinced of at this point is that this mod actually makes other people notice you less, and they never did officially claim that it did so, but there are times when I feel like I would have been caught if I wasn't using this mod, times when I've tried to play it, you know, at some place that I've tried before but which never worked out. I've found them to be working out with this mod installed, like sneaking by super close to other people. Yeah, that would have, you know, in this game, if people get too close to you, even if you're in complete darkness, they can still see you. So yeah, I mean, stuff like that seems, I wouldn't call it shady, but it sort of seems like the mod makes it easier for you in these instances. But anyway, despite the mod, you know, trying to push this game towards a stealth shooter, like a tactical shooter, you know, sort of gameplay, or a tactical shooter sort of avenue of play, I personally, you know, just want to Say it more slowly. And I just realized I'm using a lot of fillers. I shall attempt to avoid that. The long section. The first time I played around that, I played this section, it took me, I think, at least 10 to 15 minutes just to, you know, sit in the recesses and wait for everybody to pass until I was, you know, confident enough to sneak past everybody. So, yeah, I mean, I guess the game does get easier with every time that you play it. I also try, I keep trying something, you know, new, something experimental, but let's see how that goes. Oh, and there's also something new that I noticed here. I mean, as soon as you step into this recess, you can see that there's a guy at the window across from us. And yeah, I had actually never noticed that before. I just take off my night visions here to check at this point. Yeah. I don't really know what they were trying to do with that guy, whether they were unsure of the level design at first, but that guy seems a little, you know, unnecessary considering how you're in the shadow anyways, so the guy can not notice you no matter what. But well, it is what it is. I mean, I don't know about this guy though. Maybe it's to warn players that there are actually people inside the buildings who are patrolling and looking out, and we just hide in this recess to let this guy pass. And I take one look at the ledge in front of me and I try jumping onto it and grabbing it, but yeah, Sam decides that it would make the mission too easy and refuses to grab onto the ledge instead. He likes his missions hard, the same way he likes his chicken, if you know what I mean. Anyway, so I gave up on that, you know, strategy, that tactic, and I decided to just let this guy return before I make a move into the courtyard section. Now, here's where things get interesting. Even though I could not grab the ledge, I realized that I can actually probably wall jump onto the roof over there. And that is practically what I did. And even though the execution was not perfect, it actually does make things significantly easier because it does not distract the guy that's, you know, standing guard down there. So if we can distract him later rather than sooner, we can only like play it to our advantage. And this sequence actually took me 10 to 15 minutes to come through, but I think this is probably the best solution to this particular section right here. Because last time I tried this, I had been, you know, waiting behind the guard, just stuck to the wall for a good deal of like 10 to 15 minutes at least before I finally figured out what I need to do, what I could do to, you know, get past this guy, these guys without being seen. Although it is not perfect because these guys will notice you at this point in time. So what I finally decided to do was, there's also a guy up there in that window, and so what I decided to do was move a little farther from this guy so that he does not hear the gunshot go off. And it's a little realistic because suppressors are not supposed to completely make weapons silent. So yeah, as soon as he goes under that, you know, broken lamp, we shoot out the other light as well. In order to push him further into the shadows, we jump down, and here I'm just making sure that he's actually gone. And now here's the crucial part, you want to go over towards this wall. Yeah, so that guy gets suspicious, that guy up there gets suspicious, and actually goes to investigate. And using the opportunity that buys us, we actually shoot out the lights. Even though I'm pretty sure that we didn't need to, they probably wouldn't have seen us from that range, from that distance, but I did so anyway just to be sure. And we're in the clear, we're in the second section of the game now. And I think, I mean, maybe the developers intended for you to, you know, knock that guy out, but it's always fun to circumvent things in this game and yeah, just try to sneak past people instead of, you know, knocking them out, because that sort of takes all the fun out of the stealth game, I feel like. I mean, I wish they would actually make stealth games like this where you actually have to sneak past people instead of knocking them out. But yeah, they don't do that anymore. I mean, modern stealth games are all about neutralizing folks, and in fact, they actually reward you for doing that with, you know, either points or weapons. And I just feel like things should return to their original stealth roots. In fact, actually, you can't really call modern games stealth games. Modern stealth games, they're most like, you know, games with a casual amount of stealth to them. So, anyway, so here is a fine example of one of the problems with this mod. You cannot take the third person perspective or the TPP peak as, you know, as some people like to call it. You can't peek around a corner without exposing yourself, and as a result you need to rely on the subtle cues of sound to determine the position of... I was actually lucky there that the guard inside the, you know, cabinet room did not see me. But yeah, you basically need to expose yourself in order to gain information visually, or you need to rely on the sounds produced in the game to understand where your enemies are or where the, you know, where the guards are. And while that's fine in itself, the problem with that is you actually need to have a good estimate of the patrol patterns before you attempt something like this, because if you don't have an estimate of the patrol patterns, what ends up happening is that, you know, you can't really tell for sure what they're doing or trying to do at that point in time, and it can get pretty messy for you. So anyway, we just take out the camera here, make sure you're doing it from behind the curtain so the camera cannot see you.
I've got agents Blaustein and Madison. Rest in peace. Somebody cut out their subdermals. Where do we go from here?
We follow the subdermals if we can.
There's a security camera here.
Good thinking. We'll track the subdermals from the video archives. The station surveillance room is on the top floor.
So yeah, like, again, I mean, at this point I got lucky, and I mean, you do have, what do you call them, quick saves to exploit, but at this point I did get lucky that this guy was going in the opposite direction instead of coming towards me, because if he was, I would have been spotted at this, you know, point in time, minus the third person peak, that is. So yeah, just listen to the sounds, try to make it work, and that's essentially how you sneak using the first person mod. And it is fun, it is a little challenging at times, and it is fun, but it is also I don't know whether it's just this, like I said, it could be, you know, all the times that I've played this game, or maybe it could just be, you know, the first person mod, but it sort of challenges me to try out new things, like something that I'm about to try out here. And I love this conversation, by the way. It's one of the most hilarious conversations in the franchise, not the franchise, at least this game.
I'd like to talk to your superior.
Perhaps I can help you, sir.
By fetching your superior.
I'm all there is. How can I help you?
I'd like to register a complaint.
Then you'll have to ask at the desk to your right.
Very well.
May I help you?
You're the same cop.
Yes, but this is the public relations desk.
Fine. I would like to register a complaint.
Of course, sir. If you could just have a seat until somebody's ready to help you.
You've got to be kidding me.
I could easily have you arrested, sir.
So yeah, I was about to try, you know, like, sneaking past and sneaking under this window here, but I tried that like 3 or 4 times and it didn't work out. So yeah, I mean, I could have just, you know, snuck past them from behind these curtains, but well, at least I got a close-up view of how this conversation usually goes. And as it turns out, you actually can stick to this thin strip of shadows in between and not get noticed by the guy sitting on the chair over there. And what I actually tried to do there was a SWAT role, and I honestly do not even know whether that's a thing in this game, whether you know you can SWAT role or not. Not a SWAT role, not the SWAT tactical tool, like a you know crouch role. But yeah, whatever it was, it worked. Maybe it was just the thin strip of shadow in between, because I do believe I used that while exfiltrating as well. And the rest of the level is pretty straightforward. And I mean, it's the PS3 pre-detected textures combined with, you know, like the brilliant lighting, but I just can't get over how pretty this game looks, despite all the, you know, visual glitches every now and then. It looks really damn pretty. Really pretty. Especially the interplay of light and shadow. That's what I'm talking about, to be specific.
Great work, Fisher. We're scanning the videotapes now.
There, that's our guy. We got him red-handed.
Then you run his face through Echelon.
Already on it. Hey, check it out. A license plate. 84KP214.
Fantastic. Fisher, we got what we need. Rendezvous with Wilkes, your work here is done. We'll get back to you once we've sifted this intel.
So I've always wondered what, you know, about the rest of the things in the other rooms, and I mean, I did sneak into two of these rooms before, and one of them actually turned out to be a place where there's a person being held and interrogated, and the other turned out to be a place where this guy was, you know, sort of like being recorded from, you know, like from the other side of a two-way mirror, and yeah, dark. To a degree, but I don't know how it all ties up into lore. Maybe it's just talking about this general situation here. So, yeah. And that was that for this video. Thank you for tuning in. Let's just head over into the, you know, post-mission debriefing now. Tbilisi Police Precinct, Tbilisi, Georgia, October 16, 2004, 22:29 hours. The bodies of Agent Blaustein and Madison were located in the morgue of a Tbilisi police precinct. Before being sent to Georgia, the agents had been outfitted with subdermal tracking implants. These implants were removed from their corpses and taken to the Georgian Ministry of Defense by a man named Vyacheslav Grinko. So, yeah, so the story thus far is, as the maiden voyage or the maiden mission of the third echelon initiative, Sam has been sent in to investigate the disappearance of two CIA agents who turned out to have been killed in Georgia, and this is somehow connected to Nikolats at this point, and as it turns out, basically, that this is terrorist or mercenary, at least, called Vyacheslav Grinko, who has been, you know, taking care of the network. So in the next mission, we head over into the presidential palace. Wait, no, that's not the next mission. The defense ministry, to try and nail down whoever it is, or at least potentially find more information about what was actually going on here. So yeah, we'll cover that in the next video. Until then, take care. Farewell, fellow earthlings.